Now we are studying lubrication. So you are observing a lubrication picture here. So in between the gears, there is a lubrication oil is here. So we all come across the lubrication everywhere. Just imagine, my dear students, our eyes closes and opens due to the lubrication. There is oil. Even our bones, there will be lubrication oil or lubrication gel will be there. What is lubrication, my dear students? Everything, what is lubrication, purpose of lubrication, types of lubricants, we are going to study in this class. My dear students, what is lubrication? First, I'll deal with this topic. What is lubrication? So, my dear students, we know that when any metals or any mechanical parts, when they move each other, there will be friction generation. So due to the friction, noise will be more, wear and tear will be more, so that we must avoid the friction. So whatever you do to reduce the friction, then that is called as a lubrication. The process of reducing the friction is called as lubrication. And any substance you place in between two metal surfaces, any materials you place in between two metal surfaces to avoid a friction is called lubricant. Reducing friction is called lubrication. The material used for reducing friction is called lubricant. Now we are going to study next thing. We are going to study next thing, objective of lubrication. We are going to study next thing, that is objective of lubrication. We all know that, my dear students, why we use a lubrication? To reduce the frictional resistance. Just you imagine bicycle is there, bicycle chain is there. We pour oil on the chain for smooth movement. So smooth movement in the sense, there will not be much frictional resistance. So if the lubricant, second objective is what we have here is to reduce the wear on the bearing surfaces. So of course, if you use the lubrication, my dear students, what happens? There will not be much friction, so that wear and tear will be less. So to avoid to reduce the wear, we use lubricants for lubrication. Next one, what we have? This is not the main function of lubrication, but whatever the lubricants we use, that should be avoid some corrosion. That is acts as a corrosion reducing agent. And main function of lubrication is also to reduce the heat from bearing. So you only know that, my dear students, in two-wheeler we use lubrication oil, engine oil. So the function of engine oil is not only lubrication, it also cools the engine. It takes lubrication oil, absorbs the heat and dissipates to the atmosphere. So that another function of lubrication is to carry out the heat which are generated in the metal parts, so that engine will be in cold condition. And another function of lubrication is to reduce the noise from moving components of the machine. So that whenever you use a chain properly, oiled, or any component properly oiled or greased, then they make less noise. Next one is to clean the metal parts. Of course, whenever you use oils, the metal parts will be removed. That oil will be removed with the contaminants, metal pieces, wear, worn out particles, so that it also acts as a cleaning agent. And also, the next function of the lubrication is cushioning of parts. So what happens in between any two gears, in between any two metal parts, what happens, my dear student, that oil comes and stays there. For example, in case of the two wheeler, in between two gears, if the lubrication oil is there, my dear students, what that does, whenever you suddenly leave a clutch, automatically sudden impact will be given to the gearbox. So what happens? This oil get compressed. This oil get compressed, which gives a cushioning effect for the gears, so that gears will be safer. And also, whatever the vibration generated in vehicles, that also absorbed by the lubrication oil, so that to keep the engine safer. And last, an important application is seal the space between cylinder and piston. You know that one, engines, vehicle engines, or any engine, automobile engines. So what does, there will be piston and cylinder. In between the piston and cylinder, there will be small gap is there. That gap will be filled by this lubricating oil, so that whatever the burnt gases there is there, that the burnt gases in the combustion chamber, that never enters the crankcase. These are the main objectives of the lubrication. Now, types of lubrication. My dear students, there are three types of lubrication. One is liquid lubrication, semi-liquid lubrication, and solid lubrication. You know that one, engine oil, whatever we use for two-wheeler, that is either it may be mineral oil, vegetable oil, synthetic oil, that is in a liquid manner. They use where the less pressure is, where the operation is less pressure and high speed moving parts are there, then they use liquid lubrication. And high pressure, the compared relatively is the lesser speed, then we use semi-solid lubrication, that is grease. Grease is semi-solid. And next one is solid lubricants. Solid lubricants, the French talk, soap, mica, wax, these all are the solid lubricants. There are certain applications where we use a wax as a lubricants. We are not able to place either it is grease as well as liquid lubricant, then we go for the this solid lubricant.